So we just saw the Android manifest file for the first time. And even though it's an XML file, it can be intimidating to look at because it looks different from the layout and resource XML files that we've been used to seeing in other parts of the app. So I think it might be helpful to provide you some context for this file. So every app must have an AndroidManifest.xml file with exactly that name. But luckily for us, we don't have to worry about creating one. So this file is automatically generated whenever we create a new app in Android Studio. You can think of this file as a table of contents for your app. Let me explain. In a book like this, we have a table of contents that helps summarize what's contained inside the book. Similarly, the manifest file summarizes the important information about the whole app in a single place. When you install your app on a device, the Android system first looks at this file before it runs any of the code on your app. So what is contained in this file? From the last exercise, you noticed that all the activities have to be listed in the Android manifest file. Well, this manifest also contains other important information, such as the Java package name, which is the app's unique identifier, components of the app, for example, the activity names, intents, permissions for notifications or using the camera, and also it helps set the minimum Android API, which means to specify which versions of the Android platform the app is compatible on. So in the Android manifest file for our Miwok app, here's the package name, and these are the components of our app. This points to the theme of our app. This is where the app theme from the styles.xml file is applied to, so that our app and status bar will be brown. And this is where our icon is specified. In the All Apps screen of our device, we see a basket as the app icon for our Miwok app. Within the Miwok app, we have five activities listed here. Within the main activity tag, we also see something called an intent filter. Remember that an intent is a message that requests some type of action to be performed by another app. In turn, apps can specify intent filters to announce to other apps, hey, I can receive a certain type of intent and perform an action for you. This intent filter with the action main and category launcher indicates that this is an entry point into our app. When a user taps on the Miwok app icon in the device home screen, Android will send an intent to start our app. This activity will receive that intent and open up the screen. We'll have a chance to practice modifying the AndroidManifest.xml later in this lesson. But for now, let's go back to building our app.